So hello everyone. So in this video tutorial, we will be learning how a desktop, a PC motherboard will get powered on and how to troubleshoot if the motherboard is in no power state. So this diagram, which is called power on sequence diagram, also sometimes it is referred as a startup sequence diagram, will help you to understand the how a motherboard is powered on and where to look for when a motherboard is completely in dead state. So the sections that are involved in this startup circuit are a power supply connector, SIO chip, front panel, 3.3 voltage regulator, RTC battery, and RTC circuitry, which is a part of the south bridge, and a south bridge also called ICH, input output controller hub. And in i3, i5, i7 processors, motherboards, so it will be called as a PCH and an RTC crystal. These are the some components or the sections involved in this power on sequence or power on circuit. Now, from the 9th pin of the power supply connector, which is violet wire, 5 volts standby voltage will goes into the motherboard. This voltage we call as a standby voltage because it is always present before or after pressing the power button. This standby voltage goes to SIO chip. This 5 volts SB also goes to the power switch. In front panel connector, the pin number 6 and pin number 8 are power switch, and pin number 8 will be grounded. Sixth pin will receive this standby voltage 5 volts. And in some boards, 3 volts standby is used, and this 6th pin is connected to the one of the pins of the SIO chip, and that pin we call it as PANSW, means panel switch. This 5 volt standby voltage also goes to the 3rd pin of this 3.3 regulator. From the 2nd pin of this regulator, we will have 3.3 standby voltage output. So it converts 5 volts SB into 3.3 SB. This 3 volts also called standby voltage because it also comes before pressing the power button and will be present even after pressing the power button. This 3 volts standby voltage will goes to the south bridge. Now, from the 14th pin of the power supply connector, which is green wire, if 5 volts is given to the SIO chip. So the before pressing the power button, the voltage at this point will be 5 volts, and this pin we call it as PS on, power supply on. Now, after pressing the power button, let us see what happens. The moment you press the power button, until the power button is pressed, at this point it will be 5 volts. And when power button is pressed, it becomes 0 and again comes to the 5 volts. That means a high, low, high. That is nothing but a signal that is given to the SIO chip. Now, on receiving this signal, this SIO chip is expected to release a signal called power on signal, which is nothing but a power button out signal, and another signal called RSM RST, which is 3.3 voltage. This resume reset signal, most of the motherboards comes out before pressing the power button, and in few boards it comes after pressing the power button. South bridge, on receiving these two signals, if it functions well, then it releases another signal called SUSB, also called SLP-S3. This is also a 3.3 voltage signal. On receiving this SUSB signal, SIO chip makes the voltage at this point 0 voltage. So before receiving this signal, the voltage at this point will be 5 volts. After receiving this signal, it should become a 0 voltage. Now, when the voltage at the green wire, that is 14th pin of the power supply connector, becomes 0, then the SMPS comes into on state and releases 12 volts, 5 volts and 3.3 voltage, and as well as the minus 12 volts. And along with those two voltages, from the 8th pin, that is gray wire, 20 pin gray wire, we will have a 5 volts signal called power supply power good signal comes out, which is going to the SIO chip, and this signal informs the motherboard that power supply is okay, and in turn SIO chip releases a signal called EC power good or SIO power good signal, which is 3.3 voltage given to the south bridge. Now when motherboard is no power, then how to troubleshoot it? First we have to make sure that the standby voltage 5 volts as well as the 3 volts present on the board, and a power switch receives the 5 volts or 3.3 voltage, 5 volts standby, and in some ICs it will be 3.3 standby voltage is present at the supply pins of the SIO chip, and 3.3 standby voltage going to the ICH, and if the crystal is functioning, this can be tested using a DSO functioning well. Now after pressing the power button, this RSM reset or power on or both missing, then the problem will be in this SIO chip area. Of these two signals are coming out, but SSB failed to come out, then it will be the south bridge or the components related to the south bridge. And after receiving SSB, PSN is not coming to the zero, not becoming zero, then it will be the SIO chip. Even after PSN becoming zero, no power means there must be a short circuit on the motherboard. Thank you for watching.